Hi, I'm Vance, and welcome back to Repair and Replace. In this episode, I'll show you how to replace the diaphragm in a Sloan Regal or Royal Flushometer. This applies to both urinals and water closets, as the models are nearly identical except for the spud diameter and size. To begin, you'll need a diaphragm assembly, a flat blade screwdriver, a smooth jaw wrench, and a cloth. Flushometers or flush valves are just automatically timed self-closing valves. At rest, water is at equal pressure in the upper and lower chambers. This keeps the flexible rubber diaphragm closed tightly on the valve seat. When the handle is pressed, the relief valve opens and releases water from the upper chamber, which decreases the pressure. High pressure water from the inlet now lifts the diaphragm up and travels down the flush pipe. During the flush, some of the water is forced back into the upper chamber through a small bypass hole in the diaphragm. The flush continues until the pressure equalizes and pushes the diaphragm down onto the valve seat. The bypass hole size is extremely important for proper metering of water. Continuous flushing can occur if the bypass hole is blocked. If the bypass hole is enlarged, then the upper chamber will fill with water too quickly. Alternatively, if the diaphragm or relief valve is worn down or sticks to the valve, it can prevent the unit from even functioning at all. First, shut off the water to the flushometer. Remove the cap and use a flat blade screwdriver to turn the screw clockwise until the control stop closes. Next, hold down the handle to remove any remaining water. There might be some water inside, so it's best to place a cloth at the base of the flushometer. Use a smooth jaw wrench to loosen and remove the flushometer cover. Now, remove the inside cover and remove the diaphragm assembly. The flush volume is controlled by both the guide assembly and relief valve. The relief valve length will change how long the valve stays open. White relief valves create a higher flush volume. Green relief valves create a lower flush volume and are most commonly found in water-saving units. Additionally, each guide assembly uses different flow rings to restrict the water flow. When relief valves are paired with a specific guide assembly, a variety of different flush volumes can be achieved, so be sure to select the right diaphragm kit. If the guide assembly and the relief valve are in good condition, then you can just replace the diaphragm. First, remove the relief valve. Next, unscrew the guide assembly and discard the old diaphragm. Place the new diaphragm over the guide. The side marked "this side down" should not be visible. Next, hand tighten the disc to secure the assembly. Now, set the relief valve over top. Place the assembly onto the valve. Now place the inner cap over top. Hand tighten the cap, then secure it into place. Turn on the water by opening the control stop. Now test the flushometer and adjust the control stop until you get a normal flush with a quiet operation. And finally, replace the cap. If you like this video, leave a comment below. To keep up to date with Repair and Replace, please subscribe. And for the widest selection of parts, low prices, and same-day shipping, explore our website below. Thanks for watching.